be applying her moisturizer and sunscreen. So.
It's just in two parts. Here we go.
Oh, okay. So I'm going to go ahead and mix together the oil-free moisturizer that I selected for her, as well as the oil-free sunscreen, SPF 30.
Just based on her skin type?
Uh-huh, based on her skin type. So if it were...
dry skin.
Yeah. You know we have products in the cabinet for dry skin, and I would have added a little sunblock to that as well.
Oh, you mix the two together?
I mix the two together.
Mm-hmm.
And so the first thing I'm going to want to do is go ahead and just make sure that it's, you know, semi-evenly dispersed. And then I'm going to go ahead and treat her to a little facial massage. It's not going to be quite as extensive as the facial massage you offer during a basic facial. That's a little bit more pampering. And this is a very effective facial indeed. But it's just that when you typically do a chemical peel or a microdermabrasion, you're doing a little bit more technical stuff and a little bit less of the relaxation stuff. But clearly our client is very relaxed, so I don't see any complaints coming from her. So of course I'm going to go ahead and offer her just a little mini version of what I would usually do. Not too mini. Your petrissage. Get in there and get the eyebrows. It feels really good, believe it or not. So having added the sunblock in, always is going to make it just a little bit, we're going to have a little bit less slippage than we would if we had just been using moisturizer alone. So just know that. If you're just wanting to do facial massage alone, I wouldn't really mix together the SPF and the moisturizer. The SPF is definitely going to change the texture and the consistency a little bit. If I'm doing just a mini massage, it's fine. But if I was going to do a more extensive massage, it's going to hold me up. I'm going to have not the slippage that I need. So I'm going to go ahead and round it out. Well, let's go ahead and do a little bit more aggressive tapotement. And it's just a gentle slapping technique that is beneficial to the neck muscles, as well as the rest of the facial muscles as we work our way up. And then we're going to graduate into a gentle tapotement, which is going to, of course, be beneficial in increasing circulation. And it's also going to signal my client that it's kind of time to wake up, come back to life again. Her amazing eyebrows for her. If I were to see any place on her face that maybe, you know, a little bit of extra product buildup or something, always go ahead and grab a Q-tip or a cotton or something to go ahead and, you know, wipe her off. Make sure that her face looks as pristine as you possibly have control over. And then, two, oftentimes I will bring in with me just a little bit of lip balm. And at the end of their facial, I'll just ask them if they'd like a little lip balm on, and usually about 90% of the time they would like that. So I'm not making her up or anything like that. I'm not undoing anything. I'm just making sure that her lips feel as wonderful and refreshed as the rest of her face does. So, did you enjoy your facial?
I did.
Okay, good. Thank you.